There's the second game right now coming up. So have the players changed some gods? Going to be Oranos and Loki. So yes, they did change the gods. It's going to be Anatolia this time. It's actually kind of funny matchup for Oranos and Loki on Anatolia. That's not something I see very often, even in the community game, so it's kind of nice. So what are we going to be expecting here? Now apparently both are going for the same water so far. But then you could be thinking that Loki is going to be having a, maybe some kind of chance here, because this map actually is not too bad for Norse and they play it properly and have some kind of bonus from the water in the early stages. I'm just going to be slightly curious if they're going to be coming for the water or if maybe it's going to be a bit more heading towards basically a land battle, which it basically easily could. Thinking both could be going for build order that would be conducive to that. We'll see. And also, how quickly they're gonna be switching on to the other side of the water. It's gonna be also maybe a bit of a complication for the Atlantean, because a bit more idle time of the villager being sent there all across the map, and it might be therefore a bit easier for the Norse player. But you can see it's right now taking a bit more longer time to get with the temple, or temple on the water, aka dock. He's gonna be having three fishies there, a few more of course to the bottom side, and even more are gonna be coming forward. So far he's gonna be just scouting for a few more goats, looking at the town center, discovering where potentially he wants to be going a bit later in the game. But Titan's treasure, I don't think it's gonna be exactly coming into play because of the civilizations here. Because even through the Valor, the Atlantean is gonna be having a bit of a struggle with the amount of mythical units that Bubes should be producing, especially with all the food that he's gonna be getting surplus off and extra. So looking forward to that. So otherwise we are gonna be another relic to the top for unit LOS, and it's actually quite influential and important. So whoever is gonna be taking that is gonna be having quite a bit of a chance to outrate maybe the opponents even. So otherwise the positions of the town centers, how is it looking? So far it doesn't seem like it either Kiryu dies or Bubazis would be controlling some kind of gold mine anywhere. Can see he is having the next gold so far as you can see about like here. Even though with the forest it's not too tragic, wall in there and there, and it's gonna be reasonably fine. Otherwise for the opponent we so far don't see the gold. We see only one that is a bit further away, like quite a bit further away at this point. But nonetheless there still is a bit of a chance for another gold mine here. But looking how we have already four golds in the middle, I'm thinking yeah, not necessarily. Because he might be already reaching exactly the amount of golds that are gonna be spawning on this map. Otherwise, of course, inside the base, they're gonna be having two of them, both of them reasonably safe for Bubes, aka matreiuss. So to the top, we are looking at, yeah, both of them being fine as well. Even though this one is a bit more forward, it's still quite fine. And next to the tower, so for Atlantean, doesn't matter. He's just gonna be dropping a manor next to it anyway. And any kind of thoughts of raiding are going to be completely puff and gone. As so far, we are at 3 minutes and 8 seconds, and therefore, the next stages are gonna be definitely coming. Yeah, if this was any kind of other civilization than Atlantean, he would be blocking his farm placement. But obviously for him, it doesn't matter at all in the slightest. So it would be quite simple for him to be placing it, for example, the farms right on the row, right next to the back of the map. And it still would be obviously efficient. And as for the opponent, he obviously has to be paying a bit more attention to that, as he is right now protecting even the tower with right now the temple and probably placing it this way. It's not entirely like the bestest of ideas, because obviously there's gonna be not only an access route from the right, so therefore from like the opposing side, but at the same time he's also gonna be having a bit of a struggle to potentially repair it. So yeah, probably should have been placing the house on the outside and to the bottom, just to make it a bit easier and simple for him. But nonetheless, let's see if it's gonna be actually mattering or not at all. So second dog coming, time for Bubes. He is gonna be right now trying to even protect himself with a few walls. Alright. So he's kinda like paranoid at this point quite a bit. Can't see second temple. Why do I call it temple? Second dog already finished, and there's gonna be also another one all the way to the top. And you can see this is costing Kiryu Dai quite a lot of economy. Not only one villager, but the second one here. So that was like quite a solid portion of his echo, not exactly working all that well. So that might be a bit of a setback for him. But as an Atlantean, he can usually afford it. Heimdall, or rather Forsythe, is gonna be almost in. So just thinking if maybe Heimdall would be some kind of idea for him altogether, but apparently not. But he's gonna be fighting for the water nonetheless, with already coming for the longboats. And of course the Valord Oracles probably gonna be slaughtered fairly easily, not only by the Ulfsaks, but also by the boats that are gonna be coming forward as soon as possible. So there we go. His opponent is also gonna be fighting fully, but the fact is, and the difference is, that Kiluda is on the second water already, and well, all the way through bottom, the water doesn't have to be exactly all that important for Kiluda. So basically right now Kiluda, what is he gonna be doing, is keeping the fight going pretty much, as long as possible, so that Bubes is gonna be having to expand and extend his resources all of this. Whereas on the left, he's gonna be just basically free reign. And while he doesn't know that, it's of course significantly important, even though so far he's not even going for the fishies in there, as apparently his economy is a bit more strained than he would be liking. You can see he doesn't have the wood for the boats all that much, as they are gonna be at similar population limit, as right now he's at 7, whereas the opponent is at 7 as well. So therefore you can definitely tell that Kiluda is gonna be pretty skewed, and this is one of the problems for the Atlanteans on Anatolia, and why Anatolia is a bit of a tricky map, because, quite obviously, their speed doesn't exactly matter all that much. Basically the only part where it matters is escaping from fights and potentially trying to kite, but otherwise, as basically no instance where he could be like outmaneuvering the opponent at all, because you can see they are already basically across the whole strait, and therefore the stronger units of Bubes are in the end gonna be catching with the opponent with better numbers, not only because of 7 attack versus 5 attack, but also because of the difference in the hit points, 240 here, whereas for the opponent 290. So those boats just don't stand any kind of chance whatsoever in any kind of fight that's gonna be having a bit more units on the battlefield, which is exactly right now what's going on here. So of course he's gonna be drug shooting for at least a bit. Maybe he could be just right now ejecting at least 2 of them, as he needs only 1 boat for the shooting that was going on. But at least right now Bubes is gonna be also switching onto the left side for the water and trying to counterplay whatever Kiluda is gonna be doing. But so far that's a pretty big damn nothing, as the Ulfsaks are apparently gonna be slaughtered by one Murmilo. Especially if he's gonna be choosing the one that is dead first. But yeah, they certainly need to be running, as they won't be long enough for this world otherwise. Okay, so there's so far only one military barracks, nothing else. So therefore this is basically just a defense, not entirely thinking about the offense all that much. So you're gonna be switching into what is being researched, and that's basically absolutely nothing. And kind of slightly ironically enough, as I know the dock is coming forward from Kiluda on the top side, as he's recognizing that the water is more or less going to be done for him, it seems. Because yeah, basically right now when the Norse is getting such an amount of boats, there shouldn't be a way that the Atlantean is going to be making a comeback. There just has to be a massive misplay by the Norse, because just the difference is huge. Right now you can see there are going to be about like 11 boats, so this is like 55 attack by them. And 12 boats for the opponents, so that's how many? 84. So 55 against 84 damage, even though they are having like almost the same numbers. So therefore like half more damage done by the longboats than for him. That's like really way too much. Way too much, and really shouldn't be anything that... I don't think that even Bubes needs to be careful about this. He should be just basically concentrating on kiting. Just one of the boats that is gonna be dead, send it back. For example, like this one, as he was trying to do so, but it was very well played, I'm thinking, by Kiluda, because he has noticed the boat being dead, and therefore he targeted it, because otherwise there wouldn't be any kind of reason why it would be just instantly targeting it randomly. As the second dog, yeah, he kind of probably wanted to just lure him in between, just so that he's gonna be having a bit more of a chance in there. But apparently, right now he's actually gonna be losing, and what is the reason for that? Is it gonna be only because of the creation time difference? Because I think there's also 12 seconds and 14 seconds. So it seems like he's gonna be basically able to outspam Bubes, and that's a bit of a surprise. That Bubes apparently wasn't able to field enough units in there. It's 2 dogs versus 2 dogs. So that's well a part where actually it went for Kiluda a bit surprisingly to me, maybe not to you, maybe you knew slightly better, but that is certainly a bit of a disappointment, I'm thinking, for that. But at least he's gonna be also present all the way to the top, you can see trying to block it this completely and utterly, and making sure that at least this water part is gonna be his for the time being, but it doesn't seem all that optimistic considering that Kiryudai is controlling that at least for the time being as well. So far very well played by Blue. And Bubes is probably gonna be in for a bit of a problem, because at this time Kiryudai is gonna be getting much more bonus from the water, obviously, even though still Bubes is gonna be able to get something going. Oh yeah, this Pursane research. That's what the opponent is having Pursane as well. But otherwise on land, it's getting a whole lot more tricky. And all those Murmillos combined with all the BRMS is actually making for quite a fine time right next to the water. Okay, so there we go. This is gonna be now resulting into another battle this time for his life, but he doesn't seem to be all that optimistic. As you can see, at these medium throwing axemen are in, and I'm kind of expecting that maybe even Kiryudai could be heading for heroic sometime soon. Oh, he's having a lot of wood, so potentially preparing to switch into a few farms here and there, as Bubes is not even close to being housed as his opponent is, and he needs to break down for him a bit back. If he wants to be keeping the water alive, then he certainly needs to be coming back, letting the dog do its work as well, and obviously produce another dog all the way through bottom side, which is exactly what is going on. But in the meantime, there's gonna be a second TC by Kiryudai, and it doesn't seem that Bubes would be really interested in that all that much, even though he was at least trying to secure the second TC himself. But with all the Murmillos and especially their numbers, they just basically is right now winning the game for the Atlantean, it doesn't seem he's gonna be standing all that much of a chance. He's having two long houses and not exactly anything being made out of them too much. See, they're having only auto queue in here from one long house into the throwing axeman. Potentially could be finishing with this long house as well, it seems to me. But on the water on the left, apparently Blue is not paying enough attention in here. So at least Bubes is going to be able to sneak a few boats there and therefore get some kind of continuation of the water economy. But since the gold is going to be slowly but surely running out, as Bubes is already onto the second one, with the Atlantean still gathering from both of them at once. Question is obviously that for how much longer he needs to be securing gold mine, and that kind of goes for both Kiryudai and Bubes, because we are getting exactly into that part of the game. But Hyperion is on the way for Kiryudai. For Bubes we are getting at least pickaxe, but his heroic age into Bragi is gonna be also coming. But not before, he's gonna be probably losing the water on the right flank, it seems, at least for the time being. Now Kiryudai is still kinda looking at the wood there. I wonder if it's because of the farms, probably so. But at the same time he doesn't need all that many of them, it seems, maybe. Because he's having plenty of, right now, fishing boats, and it seems like he's gonna be controlling the water completely. So far Bubes doesn't have exactly enough against him. He's having at least plenty of throwing axemen right now, finished with the settlement. It's gonna be obviously working rather well for him altogether. And overall, he cannot exactly do anything with this all that much. But there's gonna be already blockage of the gold on the left side, so that's obviously something that he needs to be coming for. And looking at the counterbacks times two, it's gonna be apparently plenty of Turmas, which is maybe a bit interesting unit to be making in Heroic Age. No, that probably kinda is. You would be expecting maybe some kind of palace being so far and close by. Now pickaxe for him. Bubes is... has he already clicked or... yeah, so he's gonna be right now clicking. That's still a minute away. But Kiryudai is gonna be jumping into Mythical Age, exactly what Atlanteans really like to do quite a bit, and the water seems to be pretty much claimed for him fully at this point. Yeah, not gonna be all that much of a chance for him. Therefore, even Nereid will have to be deleted so that she doesn't eat all the population limit. Had her three slots. Two for her, I guess, and one from the crocodile. Or the crocodile, how's it called? Shark. Completely different animal. But 30 C for Kiryudai, of course, with the Mythical Age on top of that as well, with the Hecate. That's probably gonna be resulting into rather nasty Tartarian gate somewhere on the gold, maybe? No, maybe. But thing is, that right about now, Bubes is forced together on quite an unsafe situation and position, and it's really close to be scouted here. I wonder if he actually sees at least that one dwarf here. Might be actually thinking that maybe not. No, well, I'm thinking that maybe he actually sees this one on the left side. And therefore could be well aware what's going on in there, and therefore is slowly making his way to that position as well. But at the same time he of course needs to be protecting the gold, So it's not entirely all that certain, that's exactly the motivation. But just the sheer amount of the Murmillos, even though they are not even upgraded into mediums here, that is kind of scary. Even though he does have solid units right now, Bubes, and he's taking things carefully, I'm kind of be curious if he's going to be aiming to also jump into the Mythical Age right after. If he's going to be allowed to do so. He doesn't have the resources, so he's at least coming for the 30C himself. But with the Mythical Age already in, where is he going to be then casting? As he's going for the scouting exactly somewhere to the back and running out of gold. So yeah, he needs to be kind of looking for this gold a whole lot more. And he kind of is. He's well realizing that the gold on the left side is definitely risky. And since it hasn't been attacked yet, it probably speaks wonders to other multitudes and everything, to the fact that it hasn't been spotted yet. Even though it's fairly interesting that it hasn't been. So fight is already going on. She's gonna be right now with flame weapons to destroy the whole army that Kirudai has. But problem is that right now with the shockwave, even sending the ox guard flying, those villagers are probably gonna be suffering rather heavily. Yeah, and he's gonna be right now coming on top of that. Problem is that of course the spawns are neutral, so therefore they're gonna be attacking also the Murmillos and not only the enemy units. There's going to be chaos cast by Kirudai, and that has stolen at least a few throwing axemen, which is of course a bit of a help as well. And it's gonna be allowing those hero Murmillos and the normal Murmillos through bottom side to actually escape from the battle. Definitely pretty big problem, because right now he doesn't have that much of an army Bubes, and therefore this TC is under threat from the spawns. So he still needs to be continuing fighting in there. Skirudai is gonna be right now losing probably this little vanguard army, but at least he does get the information where the opponent is aiming for the gold, and therefore where he needs to be going with all the units. The bottom side was just kind of checking, I'm thinking if there's gonna be something going on with the water, or maybe if not. So on the left side, actually, Bubes is prepared at least a few boats to try and protect as much as the whole food economy as he can, as unfortunately doesn't have anything else in the very corner. But otherwise, well, doesn't seem like he'll be making all that much of a comeback at the bottom side either. You can see it's going to be, at this point, quite a solid amount of population limit, especially together with the Nerate. So that's literally right now 9 population limit. That's kind of not a small number. So what's going on all the way to the top? Just a bit of radiant by Huskarls. And a hero citizen who actually did not notice. Okay, that's a bit of a costly loss. So apparently this one village is also rather nearby. Rather nearby to the death here. And well, on the left side apparently still continuing with the water. And that's something that might be playing into Bubes' card, because it could be giving him a bit more extra time to get the units going, and especially start getting the battle boars going. As unfortunately though, he needs to be getting rid of the old Lampage, because the Hercules ability to completely confuse, for example, the mythical units is rather powerful. And if it's micro well, exactly as what Kirudai did now, then it can be definitely quite problematic and quite nasty. And he should be careful not to aggro the boar on him. Because so far the boar is actually aggroed on red. That's right now working wonders for him. So that was potentially a bit of a problem. Well, that has been handled, but still, that one piggy getting destroyed and removed is actually quite significant and influential. As all the way to the top side, there's gonna be some kind of funny walling off the trade, and that is certainly something that could be helping in the late game to the blue, or to the red against the blue. It's gonna be citizen destroyed, interesting. But of course, the Murmillos are gonna be right now the Avengers, and they're gonna be right now destroying any kind of army and units that are gonna be nearby. But so far, the game is actually fairly equalish. You cannot exactly say who's gonna be having some significant edge. Let's check on economical or the military upgrades. Heavy Huskarls with copper shields available for Bubes, whereas Kirudai is at mediums and bronze and copper. So there are differences in upgrades. Now the Lampage is finally dead, and that's of course significant right now boon for red. But I'm thinking it wouldn't be such a bad idea for Kirudai to try and produce them a bit more, because that's like never done. Let's just check out, and no he's not. Because against the piggies and against like the mythical units overall from the north, from the Loki, it actually could be fairly influential. Because if he's gonna be using the special ability in proper timing, it can be kind of like infinite chaos. Got power for him as well. Huh? You hear a dangerous amount of donkeys actually dying here. 1, 2, 3. Yeah, I've heard a bit earlier about like 4 or 5. So I'm thinking about like 5 are actually gonna be gone. So the economy of Kirida might be slightly starting to struggle. I'm just right now wondering if Bubes actually needs to be keeping those longbows here. Either he should be sending them to the front and do something with these, or just basically delete them and give up on the water and continue on the land, because it could be every single unit that he can be getting. So basically the fanatics are gonna be shredding the infantry really badly. And apparently now even the villages. So it's gonna be finally there coming from Bubes. And how far away is he? Oh, he just started. Okay, so he's still having about like minute 15 seconds before he's gonna be able to get through, and that's a pretty big problem. Because as you can see, this gold mine is gonna be conquered by Kiludai in no time. You can see even the difference in the score at a whole 1,000. And this hill fort, that's gonna be next in line, and it's gonna be also getting dangerously close to the town center, with the gold being completely destroyed. And you can see Kiludai's economy being quite fine, and Bubes is completely not fine. With only 65 gold, 64 gold and 104 population limit, it's looking really dire for him, and Kiludai is definitely right now closing in for the potential and epitomical kill. No! Why are you killing him? Kiludai, stop! Stop! He's helping you! He's destroying Bubes, just run away and let him destroy all the buildings in here. Why? Why would you be doing this? No, he's gonna be right now kicked into his chest for that. Or no, probably looking like even into the crotch or something. That was just such a shame. Hopefully, I'm just gonna be assuming he was looking somewhere else, but it was a huge, huge shame. He's right now paying for that, obviously, because if he just left and he didn't have anything in the aggro range, this guy would be just destroying the houses and everything on his own. That was just a huge shame, but nonetheless, Fimbulwinter is gonna be cast with a few wolfies actually cast here as well, interestingly enough. Unfortunately, most of them spawn to the bottom side, so they're not gonna be aggroing against the blue army. But yep, this is gonna be already a GG, because that lost DC and that lost gold especially, was just basically something that put the game beyond Matreiuss' reach. And even though he has transformed to the left side quite well, there was still the palace already prepared. That probably was also scouted by the Wolfie from Bubes, and therefore another reason to realize what actually did happen here and what would happen here fairly quickly. Interesting game, and we are therefore tied and gonna be switching into, well, a best of 3 pretty much from the best of 5. So let's check into the post game. I need to be resuming for them so they can be starting a game if they want to, not to delay them too much. And in the end, the Oranos actually broke through here, the Loki, but it was because of quite a competent play on the water. And from there on, the ability to switch quickly and quicker than the opponent, much more importantly, into the land. Yeah, that's exactly what water battles are about. Not exactly about winning the water, but rather if you have better transition into the land battle. You can see the difference in the echo, that's a huge one. 9,000, 10,000, 16,000 difference in these resources, basically 30 resources more for Kiludai. No, you can kind of guess that's gonna be helping you a bit, but at the same time, units killed fairly similar, even through the different unit count. And of course, resulting into vastly different mythic ages, but that's kind of standard. Oh, with Atlanteans, they really just jump into mythic right after. Because at that stage, they are having still pretty good and well-going echo. You actually purposefully built a narrate, Aikiludai. On the left, maybe? Okay, that's a Jormund Elver. Didn't exactly matter at the end. Yeah, he actually purposefully built a narrate on the left. This is something you don't see that extremely often. Apparently plenty of wolfies even converting the goats before they're gonna be eating them. And the military are kinda nice for Bubes until the last battle. And that went pretty badly for him. Next to the TC and next to the hill forts, the former hill forts. Can see was having good civilians, but not entirely that higher than Kiludai, because you mustn't forget these are Atlantean civilians at the bottom. So the difference is not actually that large, which is obviously also because of the water and the stage of the game. Not ever, nonetheless. GG. We're just going to check also on military upgrades at the very end. Double bronze and copper. And double copper. Yeah, it kinda is what happens at that point. GG.